So you have your outline and it's time to make your poster. What do? The first thing you do is you create your template. Hopefully you found a template that someone has already created in your lab or maybe your institution provided. Sometimes conferences provide templates. If you don't have a template, there's lots of them on the web, and I would just recommend that you follow a template that you like and then block it out. So what I mean by block it out is you generally have the sections on a poster presentation that correspond to your abstract. So for most of my poster presentation, I always had an introduction, methods, results, conclusions. Depending on the format, I would do a background section. Sometimes it's helpful to do the background. For example, I often did math presentation or computer science presentations, and the science background was really important because the group definitely wouldn't know the background. So think about your sections, and I literally just put boxes or rectangles to just block out the areas, and then you begin the process of filling in the information. I do want to reiterate that during COVID times, we have less time often to present our posters, and very often it's done virtually. I saw a great poster with just four sections. It was the introduction, methods, result, conclusions. Really beautiful. And not a lot of words, just key figures. And it was a really great format. The person was only allowed 2 minutes. And there was just a ton of questions because everyone was so captivated on what the implications of the work is. And that's just a sign of really great preparation, great practice. And sometimes it's a little luck, right? Just getting a great result also. So now that you understand how to kind of prepare the template, let me tell you a little bit about how you want to fill in the template. So, at this point, I ask you already to have an outline. Start blocking out each section. So now, in the introduction, it's important that the problem statement is very clear and why it is important. In the methods, just include enough methods so that a person understands why you're able to make the right conclusion or that your conclusion is valid. This is a section scientists really can pick at. So really think through what needs to be there, and then everything else pull out. The results is a place where I really recommend figures. You can have lists and key results, but having really well done figures where the legends are easily readable and the appropriate statistics are there. So what do I mean by appropriate statistics? It's one thing to say there's a trend, and there's another thing to say that something is statistically valid. I can't go into a lot of detail in this shorter presentation, but it's one of the things people look for. So if you have a graph, are there error bars? And that's a good starting point. So even if you don't have the statistics, having all the data shown in a way that's interpretable is a good start. Now, the conclusions are very, very important. The conclusions are not just a recapitulation of what you found. It's really about what are the implications for the field. And so by telling the implications for the field, that's how your work often will be judged and evaluated. And it's also important for you, knowing what the implications also tells you where you might go next with your research. So that's the general idea for how you would work, fill in your poster sections. Some posters allow references. I would say just add one or two or key references. Use consistent formatting throughout the poster. You will get better at it over time, and over time you will know who the right reviewers and people to check your posters are. Pull out your spelling mistakes, and just to summarize, block out the poster globally, then block out each section, Really think through what figures you need to include, and then the probably the two most, well, three things you really want to think about. Did you describe the problem well? Are the results well illustrated? And does the poster support the conclusions you're going to make and the implications for the community? So get started on your poster. It takes a lot of time to do and format, and this is a case where starting early really will help out a lot.